I'm interested in Manraj's question though about the constraints led approach to coaching for players working out deal with those situations. I would say it's not necessarily about a constraints led approach, but it is about an ecological approach. So I've always been pretty driven by the idea of creating great environments, and if you create great environments, then those environments will allow talent to emerge. You know, the ecology of talent development is something I'm really fascinated by. Now, the constraints-led approach is one of the tools available to individuals who are looking to try and create an environment that they're going to allow talent to develop. One of the reasons I like it.
Explain what a constraints-led approach is.
Oh, okay. Yeah, good point. So the constraints-led approach is really about using environmental task or personal constraint as a means by which to help somebody improve. So an example would be if I'm trying to develop Nick's ability to pass the ball, then one of the things I might do is I might start to manipulate the time and space that he's got available in order to be able to, so he's got either more or less time to be able to make the decision to make the pass, or I might make it into a kind of a more of a 1v1 or a 2v2 type of scenario, so there's less variables for him to deal with. So you can manipulate the constraints that are on the player in terms of external variables, whether they're environmental. You can change the pitch size, you can change the pitch surface, you can change the ball size, you can change the, it's a whole range of different dynamics that you can change that bring about an adaptation in the individual, which helps them to begin to explore different ways, different solutions. One of the reasons I like the approach and this ecological concept so much is it resonates very closely with my ideas around talent development, which is that it's obviously very linked to creativity and very linked to having individuals who are able to solve problems and individuals who are really aware of the challenges in front of them, particularly in a dynamic team sport that I'm involved in. So I believe that that kind of ecological model is it's very aligned to my kind of philosophy of talent development emerging within the context of a particularly powerful environmental dynamic. So yeah, I would 100% agree with that.
Yeah, I thought you might do. Ultimately, you know, you help kids be prepared for the game that they're about to play.
Yeah, pretty much.
And kind of making it realistic and authentic to that. You know, I can remember at school, secondary school, and I still see it a lot when I go out and watch coaching now. Because you really love sport, you get down at break time before PE, get changed at the start of break time, and then go and play because you've got like a bonus bit of time at break time. Then you go into the sports hall and you play 3v3 or whoever was around and wanted to play. You'd have a great time for that 15, 20 minutes of break time or a lunch or whatever you got. Then the teacher would come in and all of that great game stuff would stop and you would go and stand in a line and you would practice your layup where you get it off that little black box behind the ring and you'd standing in a big long queue and you'd all take your times and you'd do your two steps and bounce it and do it. And then they put you into a game and realize that everything that you've been doing for the last 20 minutes made no sense whatsoever because you had a massive bloke standing over the top of you, or you came at a slightly different angle and that technique that you just practiced in isolation now doesn't work. And all the fun game stuff that you were playing for 20 minutes just gets stopped. So certainly for coaches and linking to talent, the more that you can put them into game situations and play around with challenging the constraints of that, as Stuart said, whether it's changing the space, the task, the equipment, the people, whatever you need to do, but making sure that the outcomes are linked to the game, absolutely fundamental, really. Absolutely.